Good afternoon, everyone. This is Diggs. It's another beautiful day out here in the Pacific Northwest. With all of the news going on, with the unofficial collaboration stream, with Final Fantasy X releasing, it's really easy to get lost in all of the updated details. So today, we're going to focus on one thing, and that's going to be the VC upgrades. We're going to talk about every single MR and UR VC, what the upgrades to those VCs are going to be, and how they might be used. So there is a lot of VCs to cover. It may seem like we're going a little bit fast, but bear with me, you guys. I'll definitely highlight the sort of exceptional and very good ones. The first one we have to look at here is, of course, Winter Holiday Party. It's going to give water units dex 35%. I'm not too psyched about this one. Definitely kind of like a sideline. I think if you're running Yeldira, you're probably going to be running this. Could be good. Maybe you're running water units with like little Leela and you're throwing it on. The dex can be nice. You're going to see a lot of VCs like the Keepers of the Crystal that do give elemental resistance up to specific units. So this is going to make fire units, of course, more resistant to fire. You're going to see things like Death Machine with critical evasion as well. In my mind, these elemental resistances and these sort of critical evasion cards are not really gonna extremely change how things operate in the game. I do think critical evasion may be a little bit more important, particularly with the release of Titus, but we're gonna have to wait and see. Now, when we see huge changes are definitely like the Scion of House Bilve and Horn's First Division, Solidus. Now, Scion is going to get light element units slash attack plus 35, and then Horn's First Division Solidus is going to get light element units HP plus 25%. These are extremely powerful. Like, I can't describe to you how bonkers it is that these cards are getting these buffs. It enables an entirely different look when you are running light element compositions at what VCs you're going to be using. Solidus and House of Beowulf were already incredible VCs in their own right. So you could run these whether or not you have light units in your composition. And if you do have light units, they're just going to get those extra benefits. So lots of really interesting things going on here. We have the second division, the Kingdom of Leonis Kalem card, which gives Earth Elemental units accuracy plus 25. Not the biggest deal in the world. Nobody really has a maxed out Kalem. Or I guess in reality, all of us have a maxed out Kalem. Demon Wall. I do think the Demon Wall VC is very relevant because that is a card we're going to be seeing quite frequently. And giving dark elemental units dark resistance 20% is extremely powerful, right? There's always dark units in the world that we live in. So giving your units that are dark element an additional dark resistance 20% is going to be very powerful. The Exorcist card is one of the cards that I do think is potentially a hidden strength, where it's going to be giving wind element units critical hit rate 25%. This is, of course, going to be relevant with Lucia. It's going to be relevant with Uldoa if you are utilizing Triple Trick in any way. Little Leela out there as well. While we don't really see wind elemental compositions coming in the future, we do have to keep in mind, right, that we have 2B coming as well. So this could be a pretty relevant card, especially considering some of the other card buffs. Like down below, you see Downtime, which is now going to be giving slash resistance 20% to wind element units. So these VCs that we might not have been using before are suddenly becoming maybe a little bit more relevant. Talking about relevance and resistances, this is also going to be the time where we're actually getting VCs that have strike resistance in a reasonable quantity. So one of the cards for lightning element units is going to be Blossoms in the Dark, which is going to give lightning element units strike resistance 20%. This is not going to be the only card. We're going to see this pattern repeated as we do go through here. So you're going to see kind of these buffs repeated with different VCs. And the only thing I could think of is that maybe they're trying to give each VC like a certain type of buff as they kind of transition, right? So like, we might see slash attack plus 35 for all dark units in the future. Stuff like that. Trousseau is a little bit unique in that it gives light elemental units, decreases activation time 100. not a ton of light elemental units that I can think of off the top of my head are going to be taking advantage of this, right? We have like Sakura, who's going to be, you know, probably benefiting from this the most. But, you know, you have units like Ayaka that are wind element who are casting light element spells that are not going to be benefiting with this. So this is really kind of a small Sakura buff. Golem is going to add 20% lightning resistance. Mask of Deceit. Now, this is where things get a little interesting, at least in my eyes. Mask of Deceit is going to give ice elemental units Pierce Attack 35. Similarly, Fenrir is going to give ice elemental units Attack 50%. So the ice elemental units and compositions that you're going to be running are going to be able to be uniquely buffed this way, right? Suddenly, you're not going to need to be running Ifrit in your ice elemental compositions. You're not going to be needing to run Pierce up if you are running, say, Victora and Laswell with Laswell Subdragoon. So I'm kind of interested to see where our ice compositions are going to go with this change, because Fenrir and Mask of Deceit on their own are both really powerful defensive cards. So being able to slap those on your ice units is going to be very cool. Rama is going to give lightning element units max damage 2500, which is very good. That would have been nice when we had maybe like a raid for Skahal potentially in the future. I'm not sure we're going to see a use for that yet. Clairvoyant Astrologer is going to give magic resistance 20% to water units, which is very powerful. Irresistible Darkness is going to give pierce resistance 20% to dark units, which if you're already running, right, if you're already running Dwayne and Kane, you're basically going to be getting, if you're running their respectable VCs, an additional pierce resistance 20% and dark resistance 20% if you're running them in the same party with these VCs. So this is very powerful to some of the VCs and units that are already very powerful and very dominant. Tetra Sylphid is going to give max damage 2500 to wind element units. Again, I think, like, when I think about this, I think about just like Lucia in potential raids. Not really seeing a huge use for this, but I have a feeling there may be like a niche use in the future. Odin, here comes that Odin with the ice elemental units again, giving them accuracy 25. Scions of Shadow going to be giving light element units dark resistance 20%, which will be really nice, particularly with what's coming out here in the near future. Bringer of Shadows is going to give fire elemental units pierce resistance 20%. New Test Subjects is going to give wind element units strike resistance 20%. Siren is going to give water units fire resistance 20%, which is interesting, right? Because water is already strong against fire, so it's almost like it's just enhancing them even more. Leviathan is going to give area resistance 20% to water elemental units, which is very good. So we might actually see more of a use of the Leviathan card here. Frederica's Dream is going to give lightning elemental units missile resistance 20%. Snowy Field is going to give water elemental units increased critical damage 25%. I think this is interesting. The buff to Snowy Fields with the release of Tidus, right? Tidus, of course, being a critical hit, critical damage unit. I'm wondering if we're going to see Tidus at all paired with something like, Glacella. It'll be interesting to see. The Mobius Despair and Truth card is going to give wind element units HP 25%. We also have Rose of the Battlefield, or Black Rose of the Battlefield, which will give increased accuracy 25 to dark units. Shiva is going to give critical evasion 20 to ice units. The new Susteki Dane card is going to give water HP 25% to all water units. Blades of Grass is going to give increased critical hit rate 25 to fire units. I don't think this is going to be a huge buff. Same with Becoming Stronger Than Anyone Else, giving 20% attack resistance. Really don't think we're going to see these cards used at all. Fleeting Blossom Banquet, I still think we're not going to see that, even with the critical damage 25 for dark units. The Aigaion card is really, I think the buff to the Aigaion card, giving lightning element units HP 25%, along with the unique buff that it has for Cid, is going to make Cid even, more powerful, right? You also have to consider that we do have 9S coming in the near future. So it'll be interesting to see if we have some type of Aigaion, Cid, and 9S combination, maybe paired with a limb as well. We'll have to see. The Typhon card is going to give wind elemental units wind resistance 20%. Secrets of the Heart is going to give earth elemental units earth resistance 20%. Diablos is going to give dark elemental units 20% light resistance, which I think we are going to see potentially used a lot more with the prevalence of Yuna here in the near future. Echoing Screams is going to give earth units critical hit rate plus 25. Ifrit is going to give fire units ice resistance by 20%. Again, that trend, right, where fire is already strong against ice. So you're seeing the fire kind of getting buffed even more against ice units here. Titan, I actually think Titan is a huge buff for any type of evasion composition that runs like Keton, for example, because it does give earth elemental units evasion 20. Plus, of course, Titan is a physical man-eater card. So there's going to be some really cool, I think maybe, like, especially when Keton's EX comes out, I'm wondering if we'll maybe see some type of earth semi-evasion assault composition, maybe involving Zombie Raryu, maybe involving, I don't know, Eileen. There's a whole bunch of compositions. Actually, it would probably involve Christmas Venera, actually, now that I'm thinking about it. We also see some unique killer enhancements. So Two-Headed Dragon is going to give Dark Elemental units Beast Killer 25. There's also another VC in here that gives Plant Killer up. So we're going to want to keep track of these killer cards, especially as raid and PvE content is coming around. Plant Killer right now would be really nice with the Malboros that we're fighting. Transitioning to the MR cards, I actually think the MR cards have some of the better effects for the elemental units because they do have things like status ailment resistances, which are really powerful. So the Shadowbringers card is going to give strike resistance 15% for dark elemental units. Admirer's Rivalry is going to give debuff resistance 15 for earth elemental units. In Search of Mir is going to give Beast Killer 20 to water elemental units. Fleeting Tranquility, right, is going to give increased luck 21%. And then probably one of the best cards here, I think, is the Chocobo card, which Chocobo is already a really good VC. It's going to give charm resistance to wind units 30%. That's a really significant percentage. So it is going to make almost all wind units It's going to make all wind units almost viable in any type of anti-charm composition in PvE. Vow of Love is going to give lightning elemental units critical evasion 15. And then, of course, we have the new art book card, which isn't released yet, but we will be getting on the 24th. It's going to have Plant Killer 20 on it for earth elemental units. The Tomberry card is going to give lightning elemental units 15% fire resistance. The Mobius of Hope and Illusion card is going to give Ice Killer 20 to fire elemental units. So very powerful buff there. Honest Souls Deceptive Vows is going to give wind elemental units earth resistance 15%. Chivalrous Outlaws is going to give lightning elemental units slash resistance 15%. Now, Chivalrous Outlaws is already a pretty good card, so I think we might actually see maybe more recommendation or more use of Chivalrous Outlaws, particularly in lightning compositions. Sanctum of Assassins is going to give light elemental units evasion 10. We don't really see evasion light elemental compositions, but you never know what's going to happen when maybe Ramza EX comes out, paired with, you know, something like, you know, that light elemental MR calculator. Who knows? Who knows what we're going to see? Warrior of Light, pretty evasive unit himself. Greetings from Afar. I actually like the buff on this. It gives earth elemental units 20 attack up. So very powerful buff there. Faded Clash is going to give dark elemental units dark killer 20. Mind Flayer is going to give water elemental units fire killer 20. The Sir O card is going to give lightning elemental units critical damage 18. The King Curry card is going to give ice elemental units man-eater 15 when attacking with physical attacks. The Perks of Having Charm is going to give light resistance 15% to dark units. The new Titus card is going to give water units accuracy 18. Behemoth is going to give dark elemental units attack 30%. The Iron Giant VC, which is really powerful, right, when you think in terms of MR VCs, is going to give light elemental units slash attack 20. I think this is going to make this an even more accessible card for beginning players, especially with the changes that are happening in the game right now. The Ochu card is going to give earth elemental units pierce resistance 15. The Marilith card is going to give fire units attack 30%. The Dario card is going to get, or not Dario, Durando card is going to give Earth Elemental units Critical Evasion 15. Envious Magicians, of course, is going to give Lightning Elemental units Maneater 15 when attacking with magic attacks. So that's going to be another source of magical Maneater, which could be really powerful. We also have the Snow White Guard card, which is pretty powerful in its own right in terms of giving slash resistance and shooting resistance. So being able to have light elemental area resistance as well is just really great on that. Makes maybe like throwing this on Warrior of Light or something really good in your composition. Cleansing the Mind gives dark elemental units HP 15%. Birth of New Life is going to give fire elemental units attack resistance 15. The Moogle VC is going to give ice elemental units magic 30%. The Chocobo, now I think this is probably the biggest buff to MR VCs. And that's going to be the Red Chocobo. And if you have watched my channel, you all know how huge of a fan I am of the Red Chocobo VC. Now, it's going to give light elemental units Dark Killer 20. Love it. I love the Chocobo VC. I think the Chocobo VC is like one of the strongest MR VCs in the game, if not the strongest. And just being able to give light elemental units, right? Because if you think about it, if you're running the Chocobo VC, you're running it to strengthen holy attacks in your composition. You're running it with units like Ayaka, who are casting holy to deal damage, which probably means you're going up against dark elemental units, which means you're probably going to have some light elemental units in your composition. So being able to have those light elemental units with Dark Killer 20 is going to make them even more powerful, particularly Sakura. So I would love to see the math behind the Red Chocobo now in terms of different VCs on different units, because I almost wonder if the Red Chocobo VC will actually surpass with this buff some of the UR VCs out there for Sakura. So I would love to see like an analysis of the Red Chocobo with Sakura. We do have the Four Warring Lords, which is going to increase max damage 1500 for ice units. We are on our final page. So we do, of course, have the Lamia card with strike resistance 15% for fire units. Glacial is going to give ice units ice resistance 15%. Unreaching Affection, wind units HP 15%. Path to Revenge, really powerful defense card, is also going to give fire units magic resistance 15%. We also have the Bloody Moon, which is going to give dark units magic 30%. Pretty powerful. I'm not sure I would utilize this very much. I would probably be using other VCs instead. Secret Order is one of the more popular VCs, particularly for newer players. It's going to give earth units critical damage 18. And the Marlboro card is going to give wind units magic resistance 15%. So that's it. We've gone over every single VC that's going to be getting buffed. I would love to hear from you down in the comments below which VCs you are looking forward to using. Personally, I'm looking forward at experimenting with some different ice compositions, particularly with my Victora, and utilizing some of these new Pierce Attack Up ice cards, along with Attack 50% ice cards. I am also excited to try out some elemental resistance, kind of like counter builds almost. It'll be really interesting to see what people come up with. Anyway, let us know down in the comments section down below. If you do want to support me, make sure you use my affiliate link, dig.gs/coins. You can also go to dig.gs/offer. And I'll probably do a Final Fantasy X video later today as well. Thank you so much, everybody, and have a great rest of your day.